Lil B fuck him up, Lil B fuck him up. What's up, man? Welcome back to another episode of the Lobos. Hey, yeah, and in today's episode, we have the kickoff of season 4. And who do we have to face in week 1? It's number 22 Texas on the schedule. Yes, sir. Just want to take time to thank everybody for making this Lobo series so successful, winning our first national championship in season 3. Couldn't have done it without the support of all you guys. But with all that being said, it's time to focus on season 3. Everything that happened last season is in the past. And this season, we have no easy games. We have moved to the Pac-12. The season officially kicks off for New Mexico this week against number 22 Texas. Yes, sir. And like I just said, we have moved to the Pac-12. Competition should be better, but hopefully we still can run the table and win 2 national championships. But if you haven't already, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, that way you'll be notified the next time I drop a video just like this one. Also, slide in that comment section, talk to your boy, man. We talk back over here. But anyway, I'm about ready to hop into this game, so let's get into it. Okay, we don't have any team stats because there hasn't been any games played, but we do have team ratings. And as you can see, the Texas Longhorns are a 97 overall team, 99 on offense, 97 on defense, and your New Mexico Lobos are an 88 overall team. We haven't got to the 90s yet, but we are very close. Our offense is an 86 overall. I think it took a step back because we lost Nate and our top 2 receivers and our leading receiver at tight end. So yeah, but the defense is an 88 overall. Hopefully my defense has gotten better. A lot of young guys on that side, but hopefully those young guys have improved in the offseason. Top players for your Lobos, of course, Ian Smith, the punter, Mr. Anderson, and Brandon Washington. Top players for the Texas Longhorns, we got Quinn Ewers, got a 96 overall right end and a 95 overall left guard.
Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show.
Innovation. It's time to kick off season 4.
Which team can put away the jitters of playing on this big stage, a neutral site. Excited to be
let's
in this stadium.
Let's do it again.
Settle in and start playing their game first.
Lobos and my friends.
On the pregame show, NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Fred Nessler and Kirk Herb.
Can we run it back? I hope so. Yeah. It's Lobo Nation. Can we run it back?
What?
Can my offense up the score and can my defense get a sack?
Yeah!
I hope so. It's the Longhorns going up against the Lobos.
Oh, and I hope that my team comes out and puts on a show.
Real cold taste, 0 calories.
All right, let's try to establish the run game. And we will not do that.
Williams is the guy everyone has their eyes on right now.
Come on, Day-Day.
He comes with a lot of expectations. Time will
well, that was mainly on the offensive line. It wasn't on Day-Day.
Quick out to his receiver.
They go, ow!
And he's leveled. Bring him down at about the 35.
We going for it. To the left, to the left. Run that HB stretch to the left.
Play call here. I'm not
they
sure
can't
I
stop it.
It.
Nobody can. We running the HB stretch again.
Gains his way to the 43-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Okay.
New Mexico's loaded. They've got one of
look at them numbers, bro. 5,249 yards.
Really helps.
Can he top those numbers? I don't know. It's all about the receiving core we got now. Because we know Ian can pass it.
At the 39. Get to that quickly.
And there's Corey Cox.
He's at the 20.
There's Corey Cox.
Make the stop around the 5-yard line.
Get him tackled from behind.
Screen pass.
The defense blitzed and that played right.
But the yards he picked up was magnifying.
The screen when you blitz the quarterback.
You know your girl gonna answer when it's Cox on the line. Get up through that end. Touchdown. Ian showing off his trucking skills. He drove the number one 18-wheeler right into the end zone.
Perfect play call. They looked like they played.
And we got number 3 Ohio State taken down. Bowling Green, 48-45. And that is not the BGSU that we all remember. Well, not my team anyway. They do have some names that we do remember. LeBron's Davis, Trayvon Remore, Jalen Embry, and we got Florida taking down Georgia Southern 31-28.
He hit the 100-yard mark in this one. The Gators win it.
Oh, yeah.
31-28.
Real chance to be able to go on the road and win.
Okay.
And taken down at the 37.
And there's the run.
He steps out. Got a bounce. 6-yard line. Here he goes.
How did we both go for the quarterback?
Down,
come on, man. Really...
Gets the
there we go.
Down in the backfield. Play action under heavy pressure. Quick throw.
Pick it off.
It's the ball.
And that's Justin Martinez.
Got to be pleased to see that young man come up with
the freshman
career interception. They knew
he was
talented.
Oh my God, he
was
always
quick. He takes it
okay.
Right side for a good game. Good outside run.
Okay, Day Day. There's Corey Cox. Corey Cox!
For the 20.
There you go! Touchdown! Corey.
All-time
Cox.
Leader in touchdown passes.
Here's just another notch in what's been an outstanding
doing
career.
Doing his best.
Sort of hard to
Omar impression.
How good he's been for so long.
He might be the new secret weapon.
So they prepared themselves very well to have this kind of game.
Uh-oh. Put me on the right person.
Tackle made at the 46. Fly
damn.
On the play. Let's see what it is.
Oh, clipping on the offense. Free haircuts.
Thank you.
Bring him down. Go.
28. Brought down.
Okay.
At about the 31.
Ah, right across the middle.
And he's hit immediately. Down after a nice run up the middle.
They pretty much got to score on this drive, because if they don't, it's going to get ugly. Pick it up! Ah, Christian Ellis!
Yeah, I know he dropped it.
Should have been me!
Let's go!
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
He gets
okay.
Out of bounds around the 28-yard line. The Lobos are having
we're
a
looking good
of fun
so far.
Down there on the sidelines. You can just see that everything's clicking for him. It's looking easy.
To put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
And he's got all the time in the world.
Just throw it away.
We played one quarter. The Lobos.
It's the end of the first quarter, and we have a 14-0 lead. Really would like to get a first down here.
He scrambled.
And we're going. Oh, no! Not going to get it.
Picked off.
Threw an interception.
Right around the four.
Oh, my God!
That's not how I wanted to start off the season.
What kind of call is that? With a big lead, you're throwing the football.
I was trying to go all year without throwing an interception. I know y'all probably laughing right now, but I'm serious. Damn, he got that out of his hand so fast.
nice run up the middle.
New Mexico's really excited to watch this guy grow with this defense. That was his first tackle, but I guarantee you, he's got hundreds more coming.
He's tackled
at
the 16.
The 10. And he jumped over a guy, and there's a touchdown.
Longhorns.
Man. It's crazy how a turnover leads directly to a touchdown.
Especially the blocking.
All right. How do we respond? Yeah, I was just about to say that. How do we respond to a turnover?
He's into the open field. He's to the 40. They'll bring him down at the 44.
Give it back to the playmaker.
Picked up a good looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Big Ian. Okay, Day-Day. Okay, Day-Day. Day-Day.
Finally taken down at the 29-yard line.
It's Day-Day. We ain't look no more, Craig. Oh, my God.
Hit immediately for a loss.
He actually got blocked into the path
defense is fast
of the screen.
They
blocked him right in the way.
Completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
He right
got him. Wallace McCoy. That's a touchdown. You just a baby boy. You not the real McCoy.
Making the proper
that is the real McCoy.
Playmaker for the score. That's perfect timing.
Let's throw it out.
And we have number 6 Miami leading Toledo 24-20 in the fourth quarter.
In the nation. And for Miami,
will they stay undefeated?
They deliver the perfect connection. Absolutely.
Or will they take the L and drop out of the top 10?
Miami has the edge 24-20.
No pass.
No
broken tackle. Broken tackle.
And down he goes, right around the 34.
Finish him.
Oh my God! I seen a Botello.
Hey, young man, you got knocked the fuck out.
Here's a quick throw. Then it's the sophomore.
And that's Michael Pollard with
right
the interception. And now he's hurt.
The defense here comes up with a huge interception. They've already
but thank you, my boy,
like
for catching it.
Back in the game.
Hopefully, my guy can come back in the game. They still playing us to run. We're going to make something happen.
And he's throwing long.
Corey Cox.
He's got a man out there.
Corey Cox.
And he makes a catch.
Corey Cox!
Home touchdown!
Oh, in the end zone!
He's got two touchdown grabs.
You know, this guy is such a difficult target to cover in the passing game.
Corey Cox, stepping
really
up!
Doesn't matter who's
to the plate!
Still
all right, Michael
quarter.
Pollard.
We got a lot of football left, but I gotta say,
he's back.
Teetering on the brink of a blowout.
Wasn't nothing major. Got him again.
And they make the stop around the 23-yard line.
Got him again.
That was just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
Back on. Thank you.
Middle for a nice run. Brooks picked up about 7 yards there.
Yay!
Booming kick. Paul takes it to 25. Brought down at the 38-yard line. He's got an opening. He's at midfield.
Out of bounds.
Carries the ball for a nice game.
There he goes.
There we go, Day-Day.
He's at the 20, and they push
there
him out.
There we go, Day-Day.
17-yard line.
There's Caleb.
Big play, and it's first and goal.
Caleb picking up 12. And we did not get in. We're going to walk in with Ian. Touchdown.
Once again, he finds the end.
The Heisman Trophy winner. And number 6 Miami does defeat Toledo.
Stop the running game,
to stay unbeaten and to stay in the top 10.
Right now, this defense does not have the answer to slow him down.
The Hurricanes come into today's game.
Hopefully we can win and move up in the top 25.
Their season starts with a win.
I don't like being at number 19
in the passing game was
after we just won a national championship.
Down passes in this one. Miami wins it 31-27.
Tackle at about the 33-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. Brought down at the 42-yard line.
Had a lot of movement going on there.
Wears it out to the right to the halfback. And he's tackled at the 39.
FBI, open up!
He's on the run. Customers are going to call their second timeout. He's at the 30. He's taking
Austin Little again.
Deep ball. Lay it out there.
Oh, he dropped it. Thank you. Comes back to the box.
What a play, and that is first and goal. He gets rid of this one.
Okay.
Gets it out quickly.
And that worked to perfection.
The Longhorns always knew that this kid was going to have a great career. Highly recruited.
He ran right into the other guy.
I'm sure there's going to be many more. He's going to go for the home run.
Ain't nobody on him.
Keeps his eye on it, makes the catch.
Corey.
He's tackled right around the 38-yard line.
Y'all better D up.
Now he tries to buy some time.
Throw it away.
Throws this one away.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
I threw that right at him. Oh my God.
There you go. If you're going to come back in this game, it's going to start with one play. And maybe that pick is what turns things around for you.
I don't know why I even tried that.
Most likely throw one towards the end zone here. He wants it all going long.
And it was caught. Oh my God. Caught off of the deflection.
Football remaining. The Lobos with a 3-touchdown advantage.
But we have a 21-point lead. 21-21-21.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football.
Even though I didn't turn the ball over.
Presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half.
Offensive good performance by my
get
defense.
A lot of attention in college football these days, understandably so. A lot of
average performance by
sport.
Me.
I don't know if this is innovation as much as just execution and explosive playmaking.
Yeah, and there's always
like I know better than to throw passes like that, and I still throw them.
You can see them when they start to get into it, and everything just goes perfect. And right now, that's the rhythm and flow. I mean, right now. Everything that
kind of makes me crazy, don't it?
To be working, and that's a special skill. It's
they have two. Well,
can do it.
My defense has two interceptions. Their defense has two interceptions.
Now, passing it will, running it will, really picking good spots for both of those plays for whether it's a run or a
we
pass.
We ran the ball better.
It's working really
we
well.
Passed
David's
it better.
Ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed
only
up.
Only thing keeping them in the game
the
is us turning the ball over.
Be a gain of 9. That brings up second and 9. Lateral's back. Here he goes. Gets out to around the 45. Counter play. Taken down to the backfield. And that run
Caleb
got
Jackson.
Stuck.
Oh my
quick strike
God.
To the receiver. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line.
There.
Right around the 46-yard line. He's lucky.
Justin
just
Martinez.
To get
and there's a fake.
Fuck! What? Damn it!
And oh my God.
He's knocked out of bounds at the 27.
How am
line.
I in punt safe? And we still can't defend the fake punt.
This is absolute bullshit!
down once again.
Nope.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Bitch.
Here's a touchdown.
He's in for the score, and they're back in it.
Oh, fucking do it again.
He really plowed his way into the end zone.
Gotta stop turning the ball over, bro.
Once you get inside the 10,
taken down as he works the left for a nice game. Lofting it out.
And they did it again.
Wide open.
They did it again. It's Corey Cox.
He scores. What a play. That's his third touchdown catch of the ball game.
Yeah, into the end zone again.
Catching every single ball thrown his way.
82 for the win. Okay, defense. Let's try this again.
He's got
an There's another easy pitch and catch.
Excellent open field tackle.
Oh, yeah.
They'll drop it for a loss.
We got him.
That's, a great
That's Damian Gilmore.
This guy's such a great player, Brad.
When and not the Dollar General.
At the award show at the end of the year.
And he was wide open.
He's at midfield. And they push him out at the 45-yard line.
The one person that we didn't need to run a route, ran a route. And, of course, he was wide open.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback.
No, a screen pass on my side. And he's short.
Around the 36-yard line.
No.
Bro!
Around the 34-yard line.
Dude, what the fuck?
Caught open field, and he tackles him hard. They'll keep it on the ground again.
Bring him down.
Tackle at the 27.
He threw that out of bounds.
And he just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback.
I really don't trust them kicking a field goal either. They already faked this once.
The kick is up.
What he does, kick it.
And he nails the long field goal.
And we have an 18-point lead.
It out to his receiver in a hurry.
Okay, Al Hall got away.
Down the sideline.
Got away. Al Hall.
Al Hall.
There you go. Bobbing and weaving.
What a game this kid's having. He's
you keep doing stuff like this, huh? You might get a DUI.
Great blocking up
he was swerving.
And his receivers are making plays.
Nearly so missing.
Credit to the quarterback.
The opposition.
For getting things done.
Oh my God, he on X Games mode.
He rifles it to the right.
Man, he caught
that. Drilled at the 40.
I thought it was going out of bounds.
Quick strike and he drops it.
Does that bat it down or do you drop it? Man, wide open.
Good room to run. Out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
You missed him. Missed him. And somehow he's still not down.
Personal foul. Face mask.
And let's throw a face mask on top of it.
Son of a bitch.
Slings it.
Bro, this man is throwing the ball immediately. How do they get open so fast, man?
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You
That's like 1 second.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen.
There we go, Day-Day.
Around the 38-yard line.
And that would be the end of the third quarter.
We head to the fourth.
And we have an 18-point lead, 49-31. So we still can score on the offensive side, which is a good sign. Oh, broke another tackle. Get out of bounds.
Hit out of bounds. Right around the 44-yard line.
Big in.
All right, and nobody's blocking.
He's leveled at the 49.
God damn it. Supposed to be a tight end screen, but of course, we don't pick up the blocks. On the left side. They do it. They did it again.
Complete. He's got room.
Why y'all keep leaving Corey Cox open, bro? He done tied the record for receiving touchdowns in a game. The school record. His first game starting. Throws it away.
He just gets rid of it.
Nope.
He got ran over.
They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line.
Did not.
Got him.
Across the middle. And that was a really well-played series by the defense.
Yeah.
And this one is a beauty.
And he doesn't and block him at all.
At the 26. And for Cox, he's putting up some very impressive numbers.
Corey Cox.
Well, I don't think there's any question. He's getting the best right now. This
Tyne Rick is in his first game. Start.
Physically, one-on-one. And he's got good hands. And he battles for every single throw that the quarterback puts up into
doing
the
doing his so best far, Omar impression.
Went in the books.
And they get nice yardage on that run. They keep it on the ground with a tailback, and he hits him hard at the 29-yard line.
Got him.
It's
Corey Cox.
Down, and he's out of bounds. And for Cox, that gives him the school record.
He got the record for receiving yards in the game.
You see now why they're so anxious.
He already broke Omar's record.
Hands. Once he's made the catch, good things tend to happen.
Throws it in a hurry. He's at the
That's
point.
Al Hall again.
Out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Williams again. He gets out.
Damn,
about the
bro! What's going on with
line.
The blocks outside, man?
He's at the 20.
Get out of
He's
bounds.
Pushed out of bounds. Right around the 20. They make the stop at the 17.
Bam!
And there's another interception. Oh my God.
Holding defense.
Son of a
From their own 20.
I guess that's what I get
line.
For still trying to throw
it's
the ball here late in the game. When the game is in hand.
Gives it right side. He's on the run.
Oh my God.
Down the sideline.
Oh, what are you gonna do now, big boy?
Touchdown, huge play.
Wow, when you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate.
I mean, the game is over, but still, how?
Awesome play.
I dive all around the man legs and still couldn't get a tackle animation. Of course, they're going to try the onside kick. And we're going to catch it.
And he's tackled at the 44. And for Cox, he's the newest school record holder for most receiving
yards. This man in his first game comes in and breaks all Omar's records. At least for game anyway.
And his great game has contributed to this winning effort.
Chance to do that.
Big opening. Takes it up the middle for a nice
run. All right. Yes, I took Ian out of the game to keep him from getting injured and to keep me from making his stats look worse. Probably just going to run the ball here anyway.
A 2-yard run by the halfback.
Oh,
they
my God.
They might have been able to catch the defense off
guard
with a play-action pass there. But by going to the ground.
Okay. So, I don't know what happened on that run play. Clearly, he didn't get tackled.
That's going to do it for this one. Our final
and he's a running back. He can't take a knee.
56, Texas, 38.
But we get the win. Ian has a good game, besides the turnovers.
For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nussler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.
We got some big production from the receiving core, mainly Corey Cox. But Al Hall also chipped in as well. I think he had over 100 receiving yards in the game. We was getting some decent production at running back. I mean, of course, we got two freshmen back there, so they ain't Nate, but they gonna get better. They gonna get better. This defense was a 97 overall, 99, something like that. So yeah, this was definitely not a bad defense, even though we cooked them for the most part of this game. But it's good to be in the win column early in the season against a team that is ranked in the top 25. A team that probably can easily get back in the top 25, because they probably gonna fall out after this loss. But yeah, like the way the team looked today. Okay, let's check out the player stats. Ian went 13 of 18 for 463, 6 TDs, did have 3 interceptions, but with those 3 interceptions, he did complete 72% of his passes, and he was only sacked once. Now, Ian had 5 incompletions. 3 of those were completed to the other team. Oh man, it's not funny. It's actually bad. On the rushing side, Ian also led the way there with 92 yards on the ground on 11 attempts and 2 TDs. Dede Williams had 80 yards on 16 attempts. We gotta get Caleb more involved on the running side. For some reason, they will not let me sub in Caleb Cruz for Dede, like on the depth chart. Like, he'll sub in and out, but I don't know. We'll figure it out. On the receiving side, Corey Cox had the best game for a receiver in Lobos history here in week 1. 315 yards on 7 receptions, 4 TDs. That is a whopping average of 44.9 yards per catch. And Al Hall also had 102 yards on 4 receptions and a TD. On the defensive side, we have 2 guys with 8 solo tackles, Christian Ellis and Justin Martinez. Christian had 2 TFLs to go with that and a pass deflection. And Justin Martinez had an interception to go along with those 8 solo tackles. Arsenio Petillo had 5 solo tackles and 1 TFL. So did Cole Chandler. Michael Pollard also had an interception in this game, so shout out to him. One of the best DBs on the defensive side, and he's just a sophomore. And John Walker had a pass deflection as well. Okay, we have some games around the country. We got Louisiana Tech beating Arkansas, bruh. 27-7, and we got Tennessee upsetting number 8 Louisville 38-7 in a blowout. We got Western Michigan beating Northwestern 41-38. That's a close one, went to overtime. And we got Michigan taking down Hawaii 37-7. We got Rutgers over UCLA 35-14, and we got number 13 Nevada over Cal 24-10. So currently in the top 25, a team that we defeated twice last season is ranked ahead of us. Okay, let's take a look at the game stats. We did dominate the first quarter, then we started to turn it over, but we still win the second quarter 21-14. We lose the third because we continued to turn it over, but it was a tie game in the fourth, and we cruise to a 56-38 victory. Texas won the first down battle and the rushing yard battle, but we won the passing yard battle by a landslide. Of course, we had the 3 turnovers, they had 2 turnovers, but we won the time of possession. Offensive player of the game, of course, goes to Ian, and the defensive player of the game goes to the freshman, Justin Martinez. Shout out to you, my boy. Okay, before I go to moving points and removing players from the board, I want everybody to see what I've done, and I will do a little bit of explaining. That way everybody knows what's going on with the custom recruits. We got 22 on the board. I divided 6,500 by 22. Ended up being like 295-ish, somewhere in there. But I needed to put scholarships on some guys, so I ended up dropping the points down a little bit to 275, giving every last single recruit 275 points. So I'm gonna go down through here. I haven't went down through here yet. We're gonna go through it together, and we're gonna see who we have a chance at getting and who we do not have a chance at getting. The guys we don't have a chance at getting, they're gonna be removed from the board. Just letting y'all know. So I hope nobody has any hard feelings or nothing like that, but that's how it goes around here. So Darnell Mason Jr., we have a chance to get him. He's staying. Caden Craft, sorry, but Columbus, Ohio, Ohio State is right there. He wants to stay there, so what can I do? Dexter Brady wants to come to the Lobos. We are number one on his list right now, and we haven't offered him a scholarship, so I might do that. We are number one on Smokey Potts' list. Yes, yes, because I really wanted Smokey Potts, because I love the name. We are also number one on Lightning McQueen's board. Zachary Cobb, doesn't look like we're going to get this guy. Seems to want to go to Texas A&M. We got James. Seems like he wants to go to one of the Virginia teams, Virginia Tech or Virginia. Also, Mississippi State in there as well. AJ Young seems to want to go to Texas A&M. Must be a Texas guy. No, actually from New Mexico. I don't, it is what it is. And we have Clifford Franklin, who we have a chance at getting, which is nice. Doesn't look like we really have a chance at Cole Roberts. Booger Rams, we may have a chance at getting him. Maybe. So I might just pursue that. Elvis Presley, we're only losing 110. We might have a chance. I might hang in there on that as well. We're also gaining on Logan Murdoch. So we might hang in there as well. I don't know if we need three tight ends, but I'm pretty sure we're not going to get all of these guys. It might just be Booger Rams and Logan. Logan being the one that we have the best chance of getting, so I'm going to move him to the top. And Booger and Elvis Presley. And the tackle, huge ass. We have a huge ass deficit right now. we're losing on him. That sucks. Because the name is iconic, but I just really don't have the points. Also losing on Mark. I don't believe we'll be able to get him as well. We're competing with Florida State and Notre Dame. Florida State looks like they have a big lead right now. Frank St. Martin, we do have a chance at getting him, so we're going to pursue that. Not so lucky on Roberto Williams. Augustus Cole, doesn't look like we're going to be able to get him either. Eddie Lyons, we do have a chance at getting. We are inside the projected lock cutoff on Zach Cunningham, so we might stay in there. We're only down 420. Yeah, I might look into that. Maybe another week on him. Leland Clark, we're only losing 105 points right now. We might pursue that. Doesn't look like we'll be able to get Tyrell Combs. We do have some other offensive linemen down here, guys that I put on the board. Doesn't look like we'll be okay on him. But yeah, I have a lot of recruiting to do. So yeah, a lot of guys are gonna get cut from the board. I just wanted y'all to see what's going on before I go to moving around all these guys and moving points and all that type of stuff. And I might just do the recruiting off screen. I might just do that because it's probably gonna take a while, and I don't want the recording to crash or anything while I'm trying to do this. So just wanted to let y'all know what was going on. Okay, we can take a look at the top 25 for the first time this year. Utah is number one, Georgia is two, Ohio State is three, Notre Dame is four, Oregon is five, Miami at six, Syracuse at seven, USC at eight, Penn State at nine, and North Carolina sitting at 10. Also have Oklahoma, who lost because there's a lot of movement. Somebody had to lose, and that was Louisville, the number 8 team in the country. We are currently sitting at number 19. We didn't move at all, which is okay with me because we still have a long way to go in this season. Not a whole lot of movement here. Not really concerned with the conference standings yet. I don't believe anybody has played a conference game yet. Ian Smith is the reigning, defending, undisputed Heisman Trophy winner of the world. So, of course, he's on top of the list right now. And with that performance, he's probably not going to drop any. I mean, the interceptions were not good, but 463 yards. Also, another 92 yards on the ground. 8 total TDs. It's hard to beat that. Very, very hard to beat that. We also have Jamonte Woods, that's a familiar name. Branson Robinson, that's also a familiar name. Keaton Mitchell, didn't hear about him last year. Kyle McCord, I don't know if I remember him from this series or the BGSU series. But anyway, that will be the Heisman watch. Ian Smith also won the NCAA Player of the Week. So shout out to Ian, kicking off the season the right way, besides the interceptions. And we have Justin Martinez, who won the Pac-12 Defensive Player of the Week. Let's go. And of course, Ian won that. He's the NCAA Player of the Week, so of course he won the Pac-12 as well. All right, if you made it to this part of the episode, you already know how to go on this show. It's the outro.
control.
King Kong ain't got shit on me!
Ain't nothing changed. It's season 4, but we doing pretty much everything the same. Why wouldn't we? Because we've been very successful. But we did get a win against number 22 Texas. They were number 22. They are now out of the top 25. Texas is a good team. I wouldn't be surprised if they eased their way back into the top 25. But they're not good enough to beat us, the defending national champions. In the next episode, we have number 10 North Carolina on the schedule. So we have another ranked team. Before we kick off conference play, we're going to test the team again and again and again and again and again. There will be no let up this season. But if you haven't already, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, that way you'll be notified the next time I drop a video just like this one. Also, slide in that comment section, talk to your boy, man. You already know what's going on. I talk back. I appreciate everybody that showed up to the live streams, the off-season live streams for the Lobos. We did 2 of them. If you haven't seen them, they're still up on the channel if you want to go back and watch them. If you have a custom recruit, I have timestamps in the comment section, in the description, to where if you want to see your custom recruit getting created, I did every last single one of them on stream, so you can go back and watch that if you want to. You don't have to. I know both of those streams are well over 3 hours, but they are up just for history's sake. But if you comment enough, if you hit that like button, if you subscribe to the channel, you can get on the shout out list. And speaking of the shout out list, I got it right here. Shout out to Michelle Jackson, Product Visuals, Optima Prime 870, Eric Rams, Warmaster 777, Thomas Bays, Dare, Matt Aarons, Arsenio Patillo, DRNA Patterson, Andrew Minton, Roscoe underscore 34, JK YouTube, Clips, The General, Eaglecraft, Little Hair Guy, Slapshock 23, Tim Alvarez, Tony Hawkins, Caleb Harper, Jordan Barker, Afro Magic, Smoking A609, Ethan Marlowe, Aaron Meyer, Aaron Kaufman, Cameron Hewlett, Quan D, Matthew Dillard, and Dirty Creek Sports. And like I say in every episode, I appreciate every last single one of you guys and gals for doing the things that you do. And a special shout out to Eric Rams for donating on the live streams. I really do appreciate you, man. You just don't know how much that means to a little old YouTuber like me to actually get donations, gifts. But yeah, man, I really do appreciate you. And as long as y'all keep doing what y'all doing, I'ma keep bringing you these videos. You know what I'm saying? But I am your AC. This is the Lobos series, season 4. We just kicked in the door, trying to up the score. But until next time, I'm out.